Programmable Array Logic, PAL, is a special case of programmable logic array in which the AND array is programmable and OR array is fixed. The basic structure of PAL is same as PLA. In last class, we have seen a PLA structure where it consists of an AND array and OR array. The function is implemented based on AND array computes sum of product terms and OR array groups together to form the output functions. The only difference between PLA and PAL is, in PLA both AND array and OR array programmable, in PAL OR array is fixed, AND array is programmable. Only that is the difference. And cost wise also PAL is less costlier compared to PLA, because only the AND array is programmable. Logic designers frequently use PALs to replace individual logic gates when several functions need to be realized. A represents segment of an unprogrammed PAL. The symbol, a non-inverted a triangular shape and a bubble here. So output you are taking non-inverted output, and bubble through bubble you are taking, that is inverted output, represents an input buffer which is logically equivalent to. So this is logically equivalent to a direct line, a non-inverted output, and one inverter. So inverted output, these two logically equivalent. A buffer is used because each PAL input must drive many AND gate inputs. If you consider one more representation, ABC, 3 input AND gate, ABC are the inputs and Y is the output. It is equivalent in PAL representation. How do we represent is AND gate, there is a horizontal line and the number of inputs that we are representing, ABC, these are vertical lines, and the X mark indicates there is a connection. So this represents a 3 input AND gate. Y is nothing but A and B and C. As an example to realize, so we will see one more example to realize a function I1 I2 dash or I1 dash I2. So here inputs I1 and I2. So I1, see, you can observe here. So I1, this line corresponds to I1, and this bubble, it corresponds to I1 dash. Then for I2, this line, third line, and I2 dash, the fourth line. So these four vertical lines represent I1, I1 dash, I2, I2 dash. And then you got, since you need to implement two sum of product terms, so we need two AND gates here. So first AND gate will realize I1, I2 dash. The second gate will realize I1 dash I2. So these two sum of product terms are computed with programmable AND array, and the OR array is fixed in case of PAL. So these two AND gate outputs are connected to an OR gate which will realize the function after programming. It will look like this: I1 I2 dash or I1 dash I2. We'll see one more example. Implementation of a full adder using PAL. So we know that the sum expression for full adder is X XOR Y XOR Cin in terms of XOR gate. But we want for PAL realization in terms of sum of product terms, which involves NOT, AND, and OR. NOT, AND, and OR. Only these things. So reverse process, if you try this, reverse if you do, so this can be written as Y XOR Cin. So this can be expanded, if you take one term, X dash Y XOR Cin, X Y XOR Cin bar, then further you expand, you will get these four product terms. And these four product terms need to be implemented to calculate sum. And Cout expression, we know it involves three product terms, X Cin, Y Cin, or XY. So here, as we have discussed in PAL, AND array is programmable or array is fixed. So this particular one set of four AND gates that you are observing, four AND gates connected to an OR gate, this is fixed and this is repeated. To implement one more function, four AND gates are there and that is connected to OR gate. Further, that will give you Cout. So in case of sum and Cout production, this OR array is fixed for each AND gate. So here in this maximum, it can implement up to four product terms, any function using one block corresponding four AND gates and one OR gate. So this AND array is programmable. So we have got three inputs X, Y, C in. You can observe here there are six vertical lines which corresponds to X, X dash, Y, Y dash and C in, C in dash. So six vertical lines are possible here, six vertical lines, and then we need to calculate total seven product terms and two functions. You can identify two functions. Which are those functions? Sum and Cout. Which are the sum of product terms that we need to calculate? These X, Y, C in, X dash, Y dash, C in, X dash, Y, C in dash, X, Y dash, C in dash, X, Y, C in. These four product terms and X, C in, Y, C in and X, Y. So total seven product terms need to be computed by AND array, and then two functions need to be implemented, one for sum and another for Cout. You can observe here, so these four product terms X dash, Y dash, C in, X dash, Y, C in dash, X, Y dash, C in dash, X, Y, C in. So these four product terms are computed by an AND array which is connected to an OR gate, and this OR gate will give you some expression, final implementation. OR array is fixed, AND array is contains programmable connection. After programming, it will appear. We can realize like this. On paper, we'll realize and we'll try to understand. Next, for Cout, you observe only three product terms are required, so only three AND gates are used. The fourth AND gate is not used. So only three AND gates which are used to compute three sum of product terms, and then Cout is computed. The fourth one left as it is. So here what we can observe is, in PAL summary, OR array is fixed, AND array is programmable. Second point, in the representation, each function can have four sum of product terms, sum four, Cout three. So up to four sum of product terms function can be implemented using one block. In complex programmable logic device structure, it is somewhat similar to this structure, PAL structure, where one block we are representing it as macro cell. If product terms more than four, in that case we cascade output of OR gate as input for next AND gate. So that is the internal structure. Further study will do. So there we can, it is possible to implement even more sum of product terms function. We can implement more than four also by cascading from one stage to next stage. That is allowed by the chip. Okay, students. Thank you, students. We will continue in next class.